keeps beating when we sleep. So we really never shut down. So literally, we do have inside of us an internal time clock. So that internal time clock in you knew it was time to wake you up, and it woke you up. So what we try to do with bladder retraining is to tap into that internal time clock. So what we'll do is we will help the resident to the bathroom every 2 hours. Now, if it works the way we hope it works, they're going to see the toilet, they're going to see the bathroom, they're going to get accustomed and know this is the place that I go to the bathroom. And we're going to tap into that internal time clock and help them get continent of their bladder.
Isn't it more like classical conditioning?
It is. It's exactly what it is. It's Pavlov's classical conditioning, pure and simple. So one time we had a gentleman that his granddaughter was sitting on his lap, and what she did was she jumped off his lap, turned around at him, goes, "Granddad, you peed on me." And he did. He had an incontinent episode, and he wet, and it got her wet, so she jumped off his lap. His face, you could have hit him in the chest as hard as you could and not have hurt him anymore. His granddaughter stopped coming back. She wasn't, or if she came back once in a while, she wasn't going to sit on grandpa's lap no more. Once is enough. She wasn't going to get peed on one any more times. You know? About four or five years old, cute little girl. Well, what we did was we started him on bladder retraining, taking him to the bathroom, started him through the steps about every hour, hour and a half, and it started working. Like I said, the bladder is a muscle. You can condition it. You can train it like any muscle. And we're going to talk about now, there's got to be certain parameters, like mentally they have to be alert and oriented enough to know that they have the urge that they got to go to the bathroom. Of course, that just makes sense. And the other thing is, physiologically, the bladder has to be intact. Like if they have bladder cancer, for instance, won't work. So with him, it started being very successful. Going to the bathroom, we got him up to about 2 hours, 2.5, 3 hours, where basically he stayed continent. Then, you know, we went to the bathroom, he urinated, and everything was fine. Well, we called back the daughter, convinced her to bring out the granddaughter one more time, give grandpa one more chance. She reluctantly got up on his lap, but then after a few minutes, they were talking, playing, everything was right. And so what we saw, it was minuscule that we got him continent to get his bladder control back. He got his granddaughter back, and that was the big difference. So with bladder retraining, a lot of times they'll get their dignity back, they'll get their self-esteem back, they will get so many positive things back, and in this gentleman's case, he got his granddaughter back. All shifts have to do it. So like, we can't do it on two shifts and then another shift lets them stay in bed and wet the bed. You know, it has to be done by all the shifts. Now, and what I said, there has to be an enough alert and orientation to know the urge, okay? Now, bowel retraining is different. We don't have to have the person alert and oriented. We can do bowel training on somebody who's literally in a coma, okay? And this is how it works. Let's just say you work a 12-hour shift, okay? You work 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. And every day, whoa,